गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर सरोज कुमार रंजन, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एंड कॉमर्स. राइट नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट रिसर्च मेथोडोलॉजी, वन ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट चैप्टर इन द फील्ड ऑफ रिसर्च. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. सो नाउ फर्स्ट वी हैव टू आस्क व्हाट इज रिसर्च. सो एज वी से दैट रिसर्च इज अ प्रोसेस इन विच वी फाइंड समथिंग न्यू विच इज ऑलरेडी फाउंड. दैट मीन्स वी हैव टू फाइंड समथिंग डे बाय डे what's going new or in the field of research, right? So as you say that research is an endeavor to discover answer to intellectual and practical problems through application of scientific methods. There is one word called scientific method. So everybody finds something new. So what's the difference between the common and the some empirical research? That is called scientific method. Now second one is research is a systematic effort. Definitely it's a systematic effort, because in the field of research we did the research in a very systematic manner, in a hierarchical manner, like step by step, like starting from the research problem and then ending with the conclusion and the discussion. There is too many things between these two steps. Now first one, for the research purpose we must have a common objective. That means what is the objective of our research. Now the purpose of research is to discover answer through the application of the scientific process. Here is that one called application of the scientific procedure. Very true. If we have some research problem, then must we have found some solutions. If we are going to find some solution, then must we have some data, either it is the past or it is the present or it is the future. Now to gain the familiarity with the phenomenon, to achieve new insight into the exploratory and formulative research. Research gives a new dimension, a new wings, a new theory, right? That means what comes in the next coming future, we have to find out that. To determine the frequency in which something occurs or which is to be associated with something else. That means diagnostic research. Now to test a hypothesis, definitely for the proof our result, for the proof our thesis, we must develop a hypothesis which supports that our research is going in a better way or not. That means alternate and null hypothesis through which can test the research. Now characteristics of research. Characteristics of research totally depend, either we are going to perform that research is exploratory research, is a descriptive research, is a experimental research, or it's a action research. Okay. Now the research process is a 8-step model under phase 1, deciding what to research. Very true. If we have some common problem, then we have to find out that what to find. If we have some agenda, then we can solve that particular problem. Second one is planning a research study. Definitely without planning we can't do anything. Suppose we have to plan, I'm just giving an example. Suppose we have to find a new vaccine for the coronavirus. Definitely we have to study about the coronavirus, that where from it originates, what are their strains, what are their genome type, then we will find the new vaccine of the coronavirus, right? Conceptualization of a research. Definitely we have a concept based study regarding the objective, regarding the problem, then we can find out the solution. Now constructing an instrument for the data collection. Definitely if we have to prove something or in the field of research, then must we have the a set of data through which we can analyze and find out the desired result. Please. Now step 4 is selecting a sample. From collecting the data, from where we will find the data? Definitely we have some sample size, because it's very difficult to collect the whole sample. So what we decide, first we calculate the population, then we find out the sample size, then we collect the data. As example, a few researcher collect the data 350, few researcher 450, few thousand. It depends on the nature and demand of your research. Next one is writing a research proposal. Writing a research proposal is that what to do in a which manner. That means first we have to do the introduction, then we have to the review of literature, then we have the research methodology, then we have to data analysis, then interpretation, and then conclusion. Now collecting data means it's a two type of primary and secondary data. It depends on your research, what is the demand and need of your research, either based on the secondary data or in the based of the primary data. Next one is processing and displaying the data. It's a research methodology part in which we analyze and calculate the collected data from the responses, or either we can say that it's an analysis of data. That means from the respondent we get the responses and we interpreted that how much the responses are responsible for that particular researches. Writing a research report, definitely research is a very long process. We spend lots of time, lots of money and lots of effort. So for concluding this, for the presentation, we must have a presentation report in which we put each and a small information, each and every information according to variables, according to objective, according to time and according to your research objective. Now, criteria of a good research. What is a criteria of good research? Now, first one is purpose clearly defined. There is a very clear cut representation of your research that everybody can connect with your research. Suppose the use of easy language, the friendly language, not to use a very tough and lengthy language. That means if you publish your research, then the common people can read and understand your research. Now, research process detail. That means there must be a detailed explanation of your research. Why we are saying the research papers of like the 400 pages, in the thesis 300 pages, because they explain each and every term very clearly and in a detailed manner. Research designed through plan. Definitely there is a theoretical plan work of your research through which anybody can see your plan and they can understand that in which process, in which mode you are going to conduct or which you conduct your research. Now, high ethical standards and applied. It's very important to follow the ethical procedure during the research, because in ethics, we can't make the small wrong things like the copy paste, like cheating someone other research papers and taking the other ideas. These all are unethical practices in research, right? Limitations frankly revealed. There must be a limitations in each and every field. Right now, I'm talking about in these three major factors. Like first one is time. Every researcher have a limited time, limited money and limited resource. They have to conduct that particular research in a fixed manner of time. Like they can't take the whole 5 year or 6 year for a particular 1 year research. They have the same amount of money, they have the same amount of effort. So the researcher have to complete the research in a particular limited manner. Now, adequate analysis for the decision maker needs, right? Adequate analysis, that means adequate amount of data have the respondent. Suppose we have 405 respondent and they give the responses, that we can say that we have adequate amount of data. That means 405. On this basis, we have to put our result. We can't explore our data like 405, then I can minimize the data. It's an unethical practices, or I can add some more data to find out the more clear results, right? Findings presented and unambiguously, conclusion justified. That means there must be discussion and conclusion based on your analysis. Suppose we found that, I just give you the example, that more rain will, on the basis of hypothesis, the more rain will get the more crops. And just it's a statement. But what is the fact that I can say that if there is more rain, then crops will grow more? There must be some proof, there must be some data. On this data, on this discussion, on this conclusion, we can conclude our result, that particular research. Next, formulating a research problem. See, formulating a research problem, it's a very big process that comes through the review of literature. For formulating a research, we study or we revolve many thousands of papers. From that particular papers, we can conclude a common problem, that how the researchers proceed and how they conduct the research. By gaining that idea, we can conclude and we can give one a common research problem. Now, beginning clarity to focus our research problems. Definitely, every research is conducted on the base of the problem. Improving your research methodology. See, there's too many methodology for conducting a research, but researchers should choose a very simple, a very easy method to prove that particular question, because it's a purpose of common people, right? Suppose we have some problem, then we have the solution like in common manner that everybody can get connected through your methodology. Now, broadening your knowledge based on your research area. Definitely, always do research in your concerned area. वी कांट डिनाई दैट आई एम द एक्सपर्ट ऑफ ऑल थिंग्स. नो, यू हैव टू डू योर रिसर्च इन योर ओन एक्सपर्टाइज फील्ड. नाउ इनेबलिंग यू टू कंसेप्चुलाइज योर फाइंडिंग्स, दैट मीन्स यू हैव टू इन द रिटन फॉर्म, यू हैव टू कंक्लूड, यू हैव टू राइट, यू हैव टू समराइज योर रिसर्च इन योर ओन वर्ड्स. हाउ टू रिव्यू ए लिटरेचर, इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. हाउ टू रिव्यू, मेनी ऑफ द रिसर्चर डजंट नो वॉट इज रिव्यू ऑफ लिटरेचर. इट्स जस्ट अ स्टडी ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, स्टडी ऑफ पेपर्स, स्टडी ऑफ थ्योरेटिकल पेपर्स, स्टडी ऑफ रिसर्च पेपर, स्टडी ऑफ मैगजीन्स, थ्रू विच यू कैन फाइंड द सोर्सेज, यू कैन थ्रू फाइंड द डाटा. नाउ रिव्यू द सिलेक्टेड लिटरेचर, देयर इज टू मेनी लिटरेचर. सपोज आई एम द मैन ऑफ मैनेजमेंट एंड स्पेशलाइज्ड इन ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट, देन आई हैव टू रीड ओनली द रिसर्च पेपर्स ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट. आई कांट रीड द पेपर्स ऑफ फाइनेंस, आई कांट रीड द पेपर्स ऑफ मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट. फ्रॉम दैट आई गेट डेविएटेड एंड आई कैन नॉट कम्प्लीट माई क्वेश्चनर एंड आई कैन नॉट कम्प्लीट माई रिसर्च. सो आई हैव टू स्टडी ओनली द पेपर्स ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट. आई जस्ट गिव एन एग्जाम्पल. नाउ डेवलपिंग ए थ्योरेटिकल फ्रेमवर्क, सपोज आई हैव टू मेक द डिसीजन बिटवीन टू वेरिएबल्स लाइक ए बी एंड सी. आई हैव फाउंड द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन ए एंड बी, बी एंड सी, एंड देर इज वन मॉडरेटर. दैट मीन्स ए हाउ मच गेट डिविएटेड बाई बी एंड बी हाउ मच गेट अफेक्टेड बाई सी, राइट. दिस इज द थ्योरेटिकल फ्रेमवर्क दैट आई हैव टू फाइंड द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन ए एंड बी एंड वॉट हैपन्स वेन सी कम्स बिटवीन ए एंड सी, right? It's a common theoretical framework. Now developing a conceptual framework I already discussed in the previous slide. Now importance of formulating research problem, that means how to find out the problem. First one is identification of a destination before undertaking a journey. That means I will give you the example. In a field of research I can say that a journey from known to unknown, this statement is right or wrong? We can say that research journey from known to unknown, किसी जाने हुए से उसके अनजाने पन तक का रास्ता. सपोज करो मैं किसी पर्सन को जानता हूं और उसके ऐसे फैक्ट्स को ढूंढना जो मेरे लिए अननोन हो, वो रिसर्च हो सकता है? डेफिनेटली, है ना. लोग ये बोलते हैं कि एक अनजान व्यक्ति को जानना, मैं कह रहा हूं जाने हुए व्यक्ति से अनजान को जानना. ए जर्नी फ्रॉम नोन टू अननोन, इट इज कॉल्ड अ प्योर रिसर्च. That means I know that person already, but I have to find something new in that particular person, right? So, similarly, in the absence of the clear research problem, clear economical plan is impossible. A research problem is like the foundation of the building. Please, next. Now, consideration in selecting research problem. अब हमारा ये कह रहा how to consider a research problem. First one, on the best of the interest, magnitude, मेजरमेंट ऑफ कॉन्सेप्ट्स, लेवल ऑफ एक्सपर्टाइज, रिलेवेंस, अवेबिलिटी ऑफ डाटा एंड एथिकल इशूज. फर्स्ट वन इज इंटरेस्ट, दैट मीन्स ऑलवेज डू योर रिसर्च ऑन योर ओन इंटरेस्ट. सपोज आई हैव इंटरेस्ट इन ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट एंड समवन फोर्सिंग मी दैट यू हैव टू कंडक्ट रिसर्च इन मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट, आई कैन डू, बट आई कांट गिव माई 100% एफर्ट एंड दैट पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक बिकॉज इट्स नॉट ऑन माई इंटरेस्ट बेसिस. सेकेंड वन इज मैग्नीट्यूड, इट्स अ मेजरमेंट that how much you can conduct the research. That means your level, your, if I always say the efficiency and effectiveness, I cannot match that effort and I cannot match that efficiency because it's not on my interest. Right one is measurement of concept, that means you, what is your conceptual idea, right? You have to measure that how much expertise you have on that particular research. Level of expertise, definitely I can say that a graduate student is expertise in all fields, no. They have to synchronize their idea. They have to pinpoint into their idea that have to find a particular problem. Suppose in management, there is lots of things. Like as I say in the human resource, there is job satisfaction, motivation, style, attitude. But I say that I have to pursue the research only in a style, right? That's, it will be more easier for me to do the whole thing. Like job, I have to do a research in job satisfaction, I have to do in motivation. It will be very difficult for me. But I select one small unit, then I can pursue my research. Right? Relevance. What is the relevance of your research? That means the research you are going to pursue, the research you are going to conduct, what is the relevance? What is the benefit for the society? No. Research is not only for by the sake of the degree. It's not only for my the doctoral in the front of my, no. it's for the society. That means I invest almost 4 and 5 years in my research. I invest lots of money, I invest lots of time, I invest my lots of effort. Then definitely there should be some positive outcome through which I can help to my society, to my colleagues. Availability of data. Suppose some researcher, they start in the field of something new, like in coronavirus, I've given the example, that's this time very limited amount of information present in the corona, right? If we have evidence of the data, then everybody gets started in the research. Suppose India has formulated 3 vaccines, rest of the country is seeking for the same result. But why India getting the 3 vaccines? Because number of patients are very high in India, right? So we have number of samples is very high. So through this samples, we can find the data and we can make the vaccines. Now ethical issues. Ethical issues are very important. That means we have to follow, or every scholar or every researcher have to form the ethical foundation and the ethical issues for their research. Research methodology. Now, there is mainly two, quantitative and qualitative research and mixed methods. So in quantitative research, we do the survey methods and experiments in which quantitative research, ethnography, case study, grounded theory, autobiography, participatory action research, phenomenology or observation research we did. And in mixed methods, qualitative, quantitative, form kya karte hai? We just mix and found the result. In quantitative methods, in survey methods, we just collect the data on the basis of the numbers. We have a set of questionnaire, we go through the respondent and collecting the responses like what you like, we have to rate between the 1 and 5 on the basis of a Likert skirt, right? And in qualitative research, we found the case study. Mostly cases are the open-ended. That means we know about your taste, we know about your perceptions, we know about your think and thoughts. And the mixed methods, what we did, we just merged the qualitative and quantitative data to find the more accurate result. Right, next. Quantitative, here is the definition, is that quantitative approach is one of which the investigator primarily used post-activist and claims for the developing knowledge. Like in the next paragraph, how you prepare the data before the analyzing. How we can prepare the data, that means we have a fixed amount of number, right, in which quantitative techniques we deal. Like here we say, in quantitative experiment study, you might aim to produce generalized knowledge about the causes of a phenomenon. Same here, in quantitative research, you have to analyze will be based on the numbers, method sections here, and you might include. That means it's based on the number, or mostly of the questions are in Likert scales. That means in the numbers you have to play for the collection of the data. Next. In qualitative, based on the primarily on constructive perspective, like multiple meanings and individual experiences, meaning socially and historical constructed. That means there is more open-ended question, more experiment-based question, more case study, in which we just read a set of questions, a set of explanation, then we can find out the data. In a qualitative study, you might aim to produce conceptual real-world knowledge about the behaviors. That means there is one more observational method. Suppose I say that I have to collect a data, one painter, that what I did, I just sit in the corner of the field and that observed that particular painter, that how he select the customers, right? If I have to collect the accurate data, if I told that person, I am here, sit here, and I want to observe your perception, I want to observe your reactions, then he just changes his behavior, right? So there the data is get manipulated. So observation method is one of the most important tool of data collection, this qualitative method. Now, in qualitative research, one is content analysis, thematic analysis, and discourse analysis. What is content analysis? Categorize and discuss the meaning of words, phrases, and sentences. That means it deals between the words, it deals between the phrases, and it deals between the sentences, right? Second one is thematic analysis. Examine the data to identify broad themes and the patterns. That means in which theme the research has going to be conducted. It's a theme-based, it's a scene-based, it's a step-by-step hierarchical-based research. Now, discourse analysis. Discourse analysis means to explain the words. That means if I say that I have to do a research in a particular area, that means I have to play with that particular word. I have to find the different meanings of that particular word to disclose that particular question. Please next. Now, importance of research methodology. What is the importance of research methodology? That means I have to pursue that particular research in a particular manner. Methodology is very important, that how to do, right? In which manner to do, in how many steps we have to do. First, designing a methodology is necessary for the difficulty which is going to be solved, and the researcher has to be these things, right? And the next point is, it acts in selecting the best method to solve the problem. See, in the field of research, we have many techniques, we have many methods, but we always choose the right path, we always choose the right technique and the methodology for a particular problem, for a particular question. Next one is, it tells about the output, selected methods and accuracy. That means, that particular technique I am going to use, that how much accurate. Next one is, adds is knowing efficiency of the method. That means my effort, my technique and my methodology, how much effective and what is the efficiency rate. Now, various stages of research methodology, selecting the topic of research, explaining the research problem, survey of research, reference collecting, assessment to present a status, hypothesis formulation, design of research, real investigation, analysis of information, result interpretation and report of result. These all are the research steps of research formulation, from the start of research formulation and the ending of the description and ending with the analysis of my research. Now, research methods versus methodology. It's a very important. Research method are the methods that the researcher adopt the conducting the research study, where the methodology that how to proceed the research and how to solve the research in a systematic manner. Jana kya? Next. Tips for writing a strong methodology. Hana? Ab kaise karenge? It's totally based on our objective, problem statement and research question. These are the prominent words through which we can write a research methodology. Focus on your objective, focus on your research question. These are the main two key elements through which we can choose our research methodology. These are few references, like these are the author name, these are the year, this is the research paper and where it's published. It's just an example of a review of literature, that particular author I reviewed, that particular author. It's a type of reference which I add in the bibliography. Next. I think this is the last slide of this presentation.
Thank you.
Now, thank you. In next class, we will going to discuss about the basic concept that how to interpret a data. So I hope we will make it in the next class. Okay.